Today, semiconductors form the backbone of modern technology. They're found in everything from your smartphones and laptops to cars and medical devices. The global semiconductor market was worth nearly $440 billion in 2020 and is projected to grow significantly in the coming years. However, this burgeoning demand has highlighted a key vulnerability in the global supply chain. As the COVID-19 pandemic showed us, any disruption in chip production can have a knock-on effect across multiple industries. It's in this context that nations like Vietnam are stepping in, not just to seize an economic opportunity, but also to add resilience to the global supply chain. Homegrown tech firms in Vietnam, backed by the government and foreign investors, are now stepping up their game. Their goal? To move beyond just assembly and to dive into the high-value arenas of chip design and manufacturing. This is not just an ambitious goal, but a strategic one that could place Vietnam on the global tech map and propel its economy to new heights. Sounds interesting, right? Well, let us dive deeper into what's driving Vietnam's semiconductor ambitions. It's good to note that this isn't a sudden leap into the unknown. Rather, it's a meticulously planned move, built on a strong foundation and driven by favorable factors that are unique to Vietnam. Vietnam's ambition to become a formidable player in the semiconductor industry started gaining traction around the early 2010s. The Vietnamese government recognized the potential of this high-tech industry early on and made it a priority in their socio-economic development strategy. As part of this plan, they undertook several initiatives to foster a conducive environment for semiconductor activities. Education and human resources development have been high on the agenda. Several universities across Vietnam have introduced specialized courses focused on semiconductor design and fabrication. Partnerships with international institutions and corporations have also been fostered to provide students with real-world experience. Additionally, the government's push to improve English proficiency among the population is a crucial factor, since English is the primary language used in tech and science fields. Secondly, the Vietnamese government has made strides in attracting foreign investment. They've implemented policies to facilitate ease of use doing business and have set up special economic zones offering preferential treatment to technology firms. These measures have paid off. In the past decade, several multinational corporations, including the likes of Intel, Samsung, and LG, have set up manufacturing plants in the country, generating employment and transferring valuable technical know-how to the local workforce. Perhaps one of the most notable examples of this is the case of Intel. In 2006, Intel announced its biggest investment in Vietnam, a $1 billion assembly and test manufacturing facility in Ho Chi Minh City. Not only did this project provide a significant boost to the local economy, but it also paved the way for Vietnam's deeper penetration into the semiconductor value chain. Another exciting development is the emergence of homegrown Vietnamese firms venturing into the semiconductor sector. Take, for instance, FTP Corporation, one of Vietnam's leading IT service companies. In late 2022, the company launched the world's first semiconductor chips, marking a significant milestone in Vietnam's journey towards becoming a chip-making nation. Meanwhile, Vinsmart, a member of Vingroup, one of Vietnam's largest private conglomerates, has partnered with the world's leading technology firms to produce 5G chips, showcasing Vietnam's aspiration to play in the big leagues. Such initiatives highlight the immense potential of Vietnamese firms in scaling up and integrating deeper into the global semiconductor supply chain. But it's not just the large corporations that are making waves. Several Vietnamese startups are also making their mark on the industry. These firms are specializing in niche areas of the semiconductor value chain, such as chip design or specialized manufacturing processes, thereby adding more breadth and depth to the local semiconductor ecosystem. All these developments indicate that Vietnam is not just dipping its toes, but diving headlong into the semiconductor pool. But as with any ambitious endeavor, this path is not without its challenges. We'll discuss those in our next section, so stay tuned. As we shift our lens from the achievements, let's now address the elephant in the room, the challenges. While Vietnam has come a long way in establishing itself in the global semiconductor industry, it's important to acknowledge that the journey ahead is not devoid of obstacles. One of the significant challenges is the lack of deep expertise in semiconductor manufacturing. While Vietnam has made commendable progress in developing its human capital, the fact remains that semiconductor manufacturing is an incredibly complex and intricate process. It requires highly skilled engineers and technicians with deep knowledge and years of experience, something that Vietnam, as a relative newcomer to the field, lacks. However, the country is not sitting idle in the face of this challenge. To bridge the skills gap, Vietnam has been actively collaborating with global tech giants and renowned universities to train its workforce. Intel, for example, has established several education programs in Vietnam aimed at fostering talent in the semiconductor industry. Meanwhile, local universities are increasingly offering specialized courses in microelectronics and semiconductor technology, often in partnership with industry leaders. Another roadblock is the high cost of semiconductor manufacturing. Setting up a modern semiconductor fabrication plant can cost several billion dollars, not to mention the running costs, which are also very high. Furthermore, the industry is notorious for its cyclical nature, which means there are periods of high demand followed by periods of severe contraction. This can make it a risky endeavor, especially for a country like Vietnam, which is still in the early stages of its semiconductor journey. To overcome this, Vietnam has been trying to attract foreign investments into its semiconductor industry. The government has rolled out a slew of new incentives, including tax breaks and low-cost land leases to lure multinational corporations. This strategy seems to be bearing fruit, with companies like Samsung and Intel ramping up their investments in the country. While these challenges are certainly daunting, they're not insurmountable. With the right strategies and continued investment in infrastructure and human capital, Vietnam could overcome these hurdles and realize its dream of becoming a major player in the semiconductor industry. In the final part of our journey, we'll look at what this all means for Vietnam, its people, and the global semiconductor industry. Stick around as we bring this fascinating narrative to a close. Now, let's bring our narrative to a close by discussing what Vietnam's ambitions in the semiconductor industry mean for the country and the global landscape of chip production. Vietnam's journey into the chip-making sector brings enormous potential benefits for its economy. Currently, the country is well regarded as a manufacturing hub for electronic products, but these are typically low-value components. Stepping into semiconductor manufacturing allows Vietnam to move up the value chain, bringing higher revenues and creating high-skilled jobs. This evolution can significantly boost Vietnam's economic growth and contribute to its transition to a knowledge-based economy. For the Vietnamese people, this means an influx of high-paying, highly skilled jobs, and a chance to be part of an industry at the forefront of technology. The spin-offs from a robust semiconductor industry also have the potential to spur innovation and growth in other sectors, including software development, data science, and IoT, further widening the opportunities for the Vietnamese workforce. For the global semiconductor industry, Vietnam's entry as a potential chip maker can bring a much-needed diversification in the supply chain. The global chip shortage highlighted the risks of concentrating production in a handful of nations. Vietnam's participation could help create a more resilient global supply chain, reducing the likelihood of similar crises in the future. Moreover, as Southeast Asia becomes a hotspot for digital growth and innovation, having a regional semiconductor production hub could facilitate faster, more efficient supply of crucial components, benefiting many industries. In conclusion, while Vietnam's journey into the chip-making world is just beginning and there are significant challenges to overcome, its ambition and determination holds great promise. With strategic investments, collaborations, and the continued development of its human capital, Vietnam has the potential to become an important player in the global semiconductor industry. But anyway, do let us know what you think. Thanks for watching.